Mesh Generation in Unity. With just a few lines of code, you can create your own Minecraft world. In the next 5 minutes, I show you how you can create a complete world in Unity. So we start by creating an empty object. We call it image object, and we add a component. Type in raw image, and the width and height will be the size of our world. Next, we create a 3D object, click on cube, and that will be our mesh for our world. We go on the web browser and type in noise map. You can use any noise map that you want. I take the default Unity one and drag and drop it in your scene. That's it for now, and for the next day we create the script. So go on create C# script and call it procedural mesh. Let's open it, and first we need to import another library to access the image. And first we need a serialized file for the image, because we want to also public and private accessible in the scene view. We create a texture, and also we create the width and height of our texture as an integer. And a map height that will be public accessible in the scene viewer, and also a game object for our cube. In the start method, we type in a function that we will define later. And now we will use an awake function. And in this awake function, we want to import the texture width and height of our image, and or better to say on from our noise map. And this width and height we want to assign it to our integer value texture width and height. That's it for now, and now we create the generate function where we generate the mesh. For this we need 3 for loops. In the first for loop we will assign the x-axis, so because we need every value of our pixel in the texture, and the x value will go on the x-axis. And the next for loop in this x-axis loop will be our y value. So with these two for loops, we can assign, or we can access every single pixel in our noise map. And we need this because we want to measure the pixel value, or better to say, the color of the pixel. Because I give you an example: if the pixel is completely black, the value is 1, and if it is completely white, the value is 0. So we want to get the pixel color, and with this pixel color we create another for loop. And in this for loop we want to create the actual mesh. So we need a map height. This means you multiplicate it with the pixel value, and as higher the number is, as more cubes we will generate. So we generate another game object, which will be the actual mesh. And this mesh we want to position on the pixel in our texture. And we choose the E in the new vector, because we want to stack it up. So every as higher the pixel value, as more meshes should be stacked up on this specific pixel. So local scale you could ignore, but I just want to have every mesh the same size. And same goes with transparent with transform parent. That's actually it for the script. We drag it on the image object, and we choose noise map and make it read and write enabled. And let's drag it in the texture slot of our script, and also the image object itself, and the cube we want to generate. Let's choose a map height. I choose 15 in this case. And that's it. Click on play. And as you can see, let's go on scene view. There's our noise map as a complete mesh world. It's amazing. Now you can create your own noise maps or whatever you want and create completely Minecraft worlds with just a few lines of code. And if you want to have a texture on it, then I just Googled Minecraft texture and unwrapped it, and that's actually everything I did. Thank you for watching.